Hello friends, today's expression is the sweet tamarind chutney or imli ki meethi chutney. This chutney is the key ingredient of all Indian chaats. This sweet tamarind chutney is a thick tamarind liquid or drained pulp that is boiled with jaggery or dates for a diabetic friendly version. The fresh ginger and nigella seeds impart spicy, warm and sharp flavors, whereas jaggery, cumin powder and fennel seeds pass on a mild sweet taste to it. This imli gur ki chutney is a great dipping sauce for chaat items such as samosas, pakoras, daivaras and so on. This video is a step-by-step tutorial for making an easy sweet tamarind chutney. Friends, it is my culinary expressions endeavor to give an expression to our culinary creations. Day in, day out, you and me may be following same methods of cooking, but each product will have a unique taste because of the creator's own expression and passion. Hence, my culinary expressions not only demonstrates the method but also gives tips and options wherever possible so that you can maneuver your expression in your style. Be sure to subscribe to receive these expressions. For those of you who are visiting this channel for the first time, click on the subscription button and press the bell icon to receive notifications. Here is a shout out to all my dear friends. Your likes and thumbs up boost up my passion, so please continue doing so. If you would like to share your feedback or have any questions about any videos, do not hesitate to ask in the comments box below that particular video. I will be extremely delighted to answer. Now, without wasting much time, let's get started. Here are the ingredients. 75 grams of tamarind. Try to use a fresh stalk, which will be lighter in color. 75 grams of grated jaggery. You can use organic jaggery. 1 teaspoon of finely chopped ginger. Instead, you could use dried ginger, that is salt. 2 teaspoons of oil. 1/4 teaspoon rock salt or pink salt. 1 teaspoon fennel seeds, that is soft. 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of nigella seeds, that is kalonji, 1/2 teaspoon roasted cumin powder, that is jeera powder, and 300 to 350 ml of water. Feel free to adjust spices according to your taste. You'll find a detailed recipe on my culinary expressions blog. The link is given in the description box. Let's start by soaking the tamarind in water. We could soak the tamarind in normal water, but just to hasten the process, we are soaking the tamarind in hot water. We will soak it in hot water for 1/2 hour. And if you're soaking in normal water, it may take a little longer depending on the weather conditions. Once the tamarind softens, we will mash it and strain out the tamarind liquid. Once we separate or strain the tamarind water, we can repeat the process one more time with more water if needed. Here is the strained tamarind water, and the color would depend on the freshness of the tamarind. If the tamarind stalk is fresh, the color will be lighter, but if it's kept for a longer time, the color is going to be a bit darker. Heat oil in a pan and add nigella seeds and fennel seeds. Let them splutter and then add the chopped ginger. Chopped ginger gives a very good taste. It enhances the flavor of the tamarind chutney and it cuts through the tartness of the tamarind. It makes a lot of difference. However, if you don't want to add fresh ginger, you could add dry ginger powder, though I would highly recommend that you add fresh ginger. Once that is done, then add the strained tamarind water and let it come to a boil. Once the tamarind water comes to a boil, add the grated jaggery. As I mentioned previously, you could add organic jaggery, but the color would be a little darker. Let the tamarind water boil along with the jaggery for some time. Gradually it will thicken. This sweet tamarind chutney goes along very well with all kinds of chaat items like tikkis, samosas. You can check out their links in the description box. Now coming back to our tamarind water, it is still boiling. It's beginning to thicken. Let it boil nicely. Once it begins to thicken, we'll add the spices, that is the cumin powder, the red chili powder and the salt. Adjust these spices according to your taste. Yes, now the chutney is ready. It is thick enough. Once the tamarind chutney has thickened, we will switch off the flame and let it cool. Upon cooling, the tamarind chutney will thicken further. In case you want to make a diabetic friendly version of this sweet tamarind chutney, then instead of jaggery, you can add dates. Once the tamarind chutney has thickened, switch off the flame and let it cool and then transfer into a clean dry jar. Keep this jar in the refrigerator and you can store it for 3 to 4 weeks. Whenever you want to use the tamarind chutney, take out a small portion from the fridge and use it. The rest of the tamarind chutney remains in the fridge. Like this, you will be able to preserve the tamarind chutney for a longer time. For a royal touch, you could add some raisins, that is kishmish, and some chopped pistachios or almonds. Friends, I hope you will make this sweet tamarind chutney with ginger, which is also called Imli Ki Meethi Chutney, and entertain your friends and family with chaats and snacks in this cool, cool weather. Hope you enjoyed this tangy sweet expression. Thanks for watching, friends. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Very soon, I'll be back with another interesting expression. Till then, goodbye.